What was your name when you were born?
Esther Faye Collins. And I know my dad was very disappointed in me. Well, he had seven girls, and you know every one of them he wished for a boy. And here the eighth one comes along, it's another girl.
Were you named after someone?
Esther in the Bible. Queen, wasn't she queen? Queen Esther. Yeah, that's why I'm such a queen. I was born in Mansfield. It's just outside of Ardmore.
Were you born at home?
Mm-hmm. Everyone was then. I was about a year old, I had pneumonia, and I almost died. Every 30 minutes he'd say, "Don't be stingy with the oil, Mrs. Collins." They gave me castor oil and I got all right. Papa grew up in Georgia. I don't know, they weren't from anywhere, you know, far away. And Mama lived there too in the beginning. She was a pretty, pretty lady. Margie Lee Collins. Her unmarried name was Margie Lee Harris, and Papa was George Collins.
And he had a bunch of brothers and sisters. Who were they?
Minnie, Mabel, Ruby, Ethel, Dick, Charlie, Jimmy, Esther, Jimmy. That's what the boys in high school used when they'd give their football signals. They'd get in the ring, and one of them would say, "Minnie, Mabel, Ruby, Gertrude, Garnet, Ethel, Ruth, Esther, Dick, Charlie, Jimmy." That crazy. Papa was postmaster in Mansfield, but he also had a grocery store on the side to feed all of his 11 kids. It was wonderful. We were sort of like the Waltons. The Waltons reminds me a lot of us. And I was the shy one. So shy. I can remember putting a cereal box in front of me at the table so no one could see me. I don't know why. Well, actually, I was very, very shy until I got married. Lester got me out of it, telling me, you know, how wonderful I was and all that all the time. But up until then, well, in high school, everyone thought I was a big snob because I wouldn't go with anybody, I would hardly talk to anybody. It was pitiful. And I'm still, you know, you wouldn't call me outgoing. Maybe with you all I am, but not with anyone else. We really had a good family. As many as there were in our family, no one turned out bad. And that's something, you know, to be thankful for. Mama sewed all the time, and she sewed for all these eight girls. And everyone thought we had the most beautiful. In fact, people stole from us. We lived in this big old two-story house. Two different times, someone come in when we were gone and steal, and the only thing they took was our dresses. She could make anything. Oh, she was wonderful. Had this peaches and cream complexion. Just a real pretty lady. And Papa was a good looking man. He was 6'2". And after he grew older, he never lost his hair. He had this big shock of silver hair. Gertrude was my teacher in the first grade. And I was in a musical one time. I was a tree in the first grade, and even then I was scared to death. Many and varied the spring styles this year, many the shades and the hues which appear. But if you would be in the fashion, 'tis clear, you must wear a gown of green. How can I remember that? In the first grade. Oh boy. Up until I was 12 years old, I went to Mansfield, and then we moved to Ardmore. I went with this guy he moved somewhere, and he wrote me a letter and said, if I could make the perfect person I'd use for you for the pattern without an alteration. Some of the funny things boys have said to me, that's funny, funny. One boy said, told the boy next to you that I had a figure like a telephone switchboard and every line was busy. Isn't that a lie, though? And another one told me, when he sat behind me, he said, when he sat down to eat, he saw me in every bean. Crazy things boys say.
How old were you when you got married?
I was 18. And Carol was born. I think we were married a long time, several years before she was born. We had this couple of friends, real good friends. He was a veterinarian there. And they had a new baby, and we just thought she was the most wonderful thing. And in 9 months, I was pregnant. We decided we wanted one. I was in the hospital 2 weeks flat on my back. when I went home, they took me in an ambulance and tied my legs together. I don't know why. I guess so something wouldn't pop loose inside of me. After I got home, I was in bed almost a month. Lester's mother came and stayed with me. One of my friends told, she said, oh, Esther, after you have your baby, your stomach's going to be out to here and your waist is going to be great big. And I was just horrified. And after I got up, I was the same size. I said, aha! That was a fun time, too, when Carol was a baby. She was a cute little baby. And if she started crying, Lester could take her up and put her over his shoulder and start talking to her. And she'd just quit like that. He could always affect her that way. He was wonderful.
How long did you know Granddaddy before you married him?
I knew him a long time before he knew me. When I was in junior high and he was in high school, I called him that pretty boy. And I had a kind of a crush on him. I didn't think he, you know, would be interested in me. But he said the first time he ever thought about me was they were driving down Main Street and I was walking down the street and he said he told those boys, see that girl? I'm going to marry her. I didn't even know him. But I worked in a 5 and 10 cent store. He used to come in there and sweet talk me, and boy, he could do it. And we started dating. He was so nice, and he was really good looking. That was it. We started going together. We got married with a justice of the peace in Texas. But I didn't tell anyone for, probably several months, 6 months or so. Yeah, we were just secretly married. People did that then once in a while, but it's probably the best thing I ever did. We moved to Oklahoma City. He got a job with Medigold Dairy. Oh, I've got a funny story about him and his horse. That's when they had the little white, cute little white wagons and horses. He loved his horse. He just loved his horse. And every morning he'd stop in a drugstore to get a Coke or get coffee probably. And when he'd come back out, he'd bring the horse an ice cream cone. And that horse would just gobble it up. One day he was in this great big hurry, and he went in the drugstore and got a cup of coffee and didn't have time to get the horse an ice cream cone. Came back out, got in the wagon, get up. That horse would not move. It would not move. He had to go back in and get an ice cream cone. Came back out, and that was fine. That's all it wanted.
What's been your favorite house that you've ever had?
This one.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think it's the memories and all that are here. It's just as nice as I'd ever want.
What's the favorite place on earth you've ever been to?
I haven't ever been very many places. I guess out on our houseboat on Lake Draper. That was the most fun. We used to have more fun out there. It was a nice houseboat. Had a little kitchen and took my TV out there. And Lester would fish and I'd just enjoy the lake. You'll never know how much I love you. You'll never know how much I care. Dee 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 dee. You know that song? That was really popular. That was mine and Lester's song.
You'll never know just how much I miss you. You'll never know just how much I care. And if I tried, I still couldn't hide my love for you. You ought to know, for haven't I told you so? A million or more times you went away and my heart went with you. I speak your name in my every prayer. If there is some other way to prove that I love you, I swear I don't know how. You'll never know if you don't know now.